Crenshaw Castle.
Hey, y'all. How are you? Welcome to another Crenshaw Castle. In this episode, we're watching Independence Day, which dropped in 1996. At the start on July 2nd, 1996, an enormous extraterrestrial mom ship enter Earth orbit and deploy multiple saucers, each 15 mile wide, over major city worldwide, including New York City, Los Angeles, and Washington, D.C. Or something in New York City, David Levinson, a MIT-trained satellite worker, decode a signal embedded within global satellite transmissions, realizing it the aliens' countdown for a coordinated attack. Whitmore order evacuation the U.S. targeted cities, but it too late. Whitmore, the Levinson and a few other escape aboard Air Force One whilst Jasmine, Dylan, and Dada Boomer take shelter at a tunnel inspection alcove, emerging once the destruction is over. Each saucer launches a swarm of shielded scraper that decimate the human scraper squadron and military bases. He subdued the downed alien and flags down a convoy of refugees, transporting the alien to Area 51, where Whitmore Group have landed. Area 51 housed the now refurbished ship and three alien corpses recovered from the crash. Whitmore showed what he learned when they were linked. The invader planned to annihilate Earth inhabitant and steal the natural resources, as they have done to other planet before them. Jasmine and Dylan commandeer a highway maintenance truck and rescue a handful of survivors, including a critically hurt First Lady Marilyn Whitmore. On July 4th, taking inspiration from E-Dad, David write a computer virus for E-Laptop to disrupt the alien shield's operating system and devise a plan. Yeah, anyways. That's enough for one episode. Thank you for being here with us in Crenshaw Castle. This flick be fire, y'all. Watch the digital edition. Watch it with your auntie. And we'll be back real soon with another episode of Crenshaw Castle. Crenshaw Castle for life.
See you next time. Bye.